Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, students spent at least 8 months at home as advised by the government. Secondary school students, along with one primary class, resumed studies 3 months ago. Educational institutions are now required to comply with the following safety regulations: measuring temperatures, hand washing, wearing masks, and more. Starting next Monday, nursery and primary school students from year 1 to 3 will resume classes. The teachers say they have missed the students. It's been a while since the students have been back, and we are really grateful to have them. We had to make a few changes in terms to sharing learning material. We now have individual items for each student during class time. Starting Monday, all students will have returned to school. This, however, does not prevent the spread of COVID-19. Recently, teachers and parents have come together to educate students returning to school about COVID-19. Parents say the fight against the pandemic should start from home. During the week, teachers have been visiting the students at home and teaching them how to take proper care of themselves during COVID-19. They have provided masks and taught them how to properly wash their hands. With that, the students are better equipped to return to their studies and continue the fight against COVID-19. I feel I should advise my child on certain changes during these times, like no hugging, no holding hands, or standing close to others. I would also provide him with sanitizer to stay safe. It is important that we remind the children of these safety rules so that it may become the norm. This will help them start school more aware of their new environment and what is going on around them. School administrators are concerned that the number of students joining on Monday may be more than twice as many as the current students. With that, there are worries that the number of existing classrooms may not be enough, despite the fact that there has been an increase in classrooms. Reduction of overcrowding and tighter safety measures are to be implemented with these concerns in mind. From time to time, we will receive more than 24 new students in primary. In the nursery section, we can only take up to 20 students. These conditions help us keep track of the amount of students we have in compliance with the COVID-19 guidelines. Another solution includes the new classrooms built to solve the issue of overcrowding. In preparing for the students' return, we have added 10 more washing stations and 2 exits to observe the social distancing rules as students leave the building. We recently added 2 more thermometers, totaling to 10 thermometers. We have had to adjust during these times in terms of the use of water and soap. With the addition of more washing centers and material to disinfect areas in the school, we are now able to welcome back 800 students. Before this, we were only able to have around 208 students. In Muhanga District, a third of the classrooms have been completed. This will help reduce overcrowding in schools, which is still a major problem across the country. Muhanga District Education Officer Iwangaryayo Emmanuel is pleased with the progress made despite the fact that there are still a large number of classrooms to be built in the district. We have built more classrooms to solve the problem of overcrowding and abide by the COVID-19 guidelines. With a total of 308 classrooms, 131 are new and filled with students ready to learn. Guidelines have been set for students that include wearing their mask properly, washing their hands, and social distancing. We are continuously teaching them the importance of these rules. Starting Monday next week, in Muhanga District, more than 38,000 students in year 1 to 3 and about 15,000 nursery students will resume classes. Umgari Jade, RTV News.